Hello, whoever is watching this. I'm going to be doing a haul of what I got at Disneyland. I went from September 28th to October 5th, 2022, and I'm just going to show you a bit of everything I got. So I have American Girl dolls, and this is my newest one. Her name is Mabel, and I heard from AG for All Ages, Kristen, I heard from her that the new emo's outfits fit the babies, and they do. So they had a deal for, like, if you got three outfits, it was cheaper than buying just one. So I got three. That's one she came with. Got the Princess and the Frog one, and this, and it's so cute. So I think it was like 22 for all three outfits. Okay, and this is the first thing I actually picked up in the store the first day we were there, because I saw it in a video and I wanted these. So I got these at the World of Disney, and they were $30. Another thing I really wanted to get was a Pandora charm, because I started a collection and I want my bracelet to be all Disney. This one's not, but it's not anything. It's just kind of a regular charm. So I have Cinderella's carriage. I bought this there. It's a clip and it has Mickey and Minnie on it. I have Mary Poppins. This is the one I got. I got Lilo and Stitch. This was not a park exclusive. I believe it was $95 US. And then in the back, it says Ohana Means Family. Lilo and Stitch is one of my favorite movies, so I just had to get it. Okay, I wanted to get some new pins while I was there, so I bought Rapunzel. She was $10, I believe. She is the silver, so I think that's $10. You can find her anywhere they get you can get pins. I went to the Oogie Boogie Bash, and I was Rapunzel with the brown hair, so I felt like I just had to get this. It's so cute, and I feel like you never see Rapunzel's brown hair anywhere. Okay, next up are these Tiny Kingdom pins, which I wanted for my dolls. I just feel like I don't like how they're mystery packed, because I would like to pick out my own, right? So these were $19.99, and I found these were quite hard to find. I bought them in the shop next to the lockers in DCA. So I got the Cheshire Cat. This is a cannon. And then I got Pluto's name tag. And they're totally doll size. I mean, look at that. That's so cute. And I really wanted a phone case while I was there, but I couldn't find one for mine. I still have an iPhone 8, and they were all like the newer ones. So I got a pop socket, and I got Stitch, one of my favorites. And this was $16.99. I bought this in the Emporium. Okay, I bought this lanyard in the World of Disney my first night. It's actually Loungefly, and I love Small World, so I had to get it. I think it was $22 or $23. It was so handy. I'd never used a lanyard before in the parks, and it was so handy. I kept my credit card, my hotel room key, my park ticket, everything that I needed in the snap of my fingers. So I had that, and I had my pins on here, and I also had my birthday button. I did some pin trading while I was there, and I hadn't done pin trading since 2009. So I got this. I mean, these aren't all my favorites, but I got them anyway. I got a black and pink Mickey. This one is Dumbo, and actually if you're on the Dumbo ride, it's on kind of the back side of the ride on the very top of, like, anyway, it's there. And then I got Woody, and this is my favorite. I was so excited to pick it up. It's Lizzie McGuire. Oh my gosh, I was so excited. Look, she has ears. I was so excited to pick this up. I loved that show and I still love it. I can't even believe I found it. I also bought a new patch for my denim jacket. This is Stitch. Of course, I had to get Stitch. And this was $10. I found Stitch at the gift shop when you're leaving the Buzz Lightyear ride. Another thing I had to get was a Starbucks water cup. I had gotten one on my trip in 2017. And it lasted a few years and then I broke it and I used it so much. So I had to wait 3 years to go and get another one. So I chose, they had two. I chose this one and I'm so excited. I think, oh, there's the price. It was $28. Okay, this is my autograph book. It has lasted 3 trips. I'm not a big, kind of not a big fan of meeting the characters and getting their autographs just because I'm, I don't know, I find it kind of awkward, but it is fun. So I filled it up and yeah, so this lasted my 2017 trip, 2019, and now for 2022. I'll show you my new autographs. Okay, so because I went to Oogie Boogie, I got to meet Bruno, and he's only there at the parties. So, yeah, well that, yeah, I have one page left, and I didn't end up meeting anyone, so there's Bruno, and I absolutely loved Bruno. Loved him in the movie, and loved him in real life. And then I got to meet the Blue Fairy. She was at the Oogie Boogie Bash as well, because they have unique characters, or rare characters, at the parties. And then the other one I got was Mirabelle. So that was really exciting to meet Mirabelle and Bruno. Yeah. And because I was Rapunzel for the party, my mom bought this for me on eBay. Yeah, I'm not really sure where she got it from, but everyone at the party was asking me where I got Pascal. Okay, these are the guide maps. This was Disneyland, California Adventure, and this was the Oogie Boogie Bash. I'll show you the inside just in case you're going and you want to look at the map. We got a lot done. I hit every treat trail except for Maleficent, and we saw the parade. We saw Villains Grow for the first time. Yeah, so that's what it looks like. At the beginning of the trip, before we even got on the plane, my niece gave me a Stitch Squishmallow, I think that's how you say it. anyway, she knows I love Stitch, and it's my birthday coming up, so she got me a Stitch. Alright, I also bought these two. My all-time favorite movie is Mary Poppins. Anything to do with Mary Poppins, I'm googly-eyed over it. So I bought these two things at the China Closet on Main Street. And it's the only place that I saw these. And they had a whole collection. They had a teapot, they had a teacup and saucer. They had like a whole tea party set up. And that was actually the most painful part because I would have bought all of it. I would have bought double of everything or whatever, like I just wanted all of it. But I couldn't because I didn't have any more room in my suitcase and I was taking a plane back to Canada. So it's like, it's hard, right? I mean, I could have gone to the post office and shipped it, but that's a lot too. I mean, oh, could have done that. Anyway, so I just ended up getting a plate and a little glass, and that's that. This was $14.99, and I believe the glass is $14.99. There's a better look at the glass. It says United Kingdom. Yeah, that was painful, not getting the rest of it. Oh, and that was one of my outfits, one of my Disney bounds for one of the days. I made a Bert skirt that looked like Bert's Jolly Holiday outfit, and I got so many compliments on it, like so many. I thought, oh, no one's gonna say anything, but people love it. One last thing is that I actually got some more pennies. This is actually my second pressed penny book. But they actually changed the pressed penny machines when you used to put 51 cents in, 2 quarters in a penny. They changed it to putting $1 in for a penny. So you're paying 99 cents just to get a penny or a dollar. So, yeah, it's kind of not fun anymore because, like, you don't get to put the penny in yourself or anything. And it's just kind of like the machine sucks up your dollar bill. Anyway, it was still fun because I still love pressed pennies. And then I got this. This was at the Penny Arcade on Main Street. I didn't need it, but I thought, what the heck? It costs $5, and it is Elliot from Pete's Dragon and also the Main Street Electrical Parade. It's for the 50th. And then here are some of my new coins. I got a few doubles, but then I also got a few that I don't have. Hey, that is all for this trip. I also got a shirt that says, feels good to be home. It has a castle. It's blue. It's kind of like a sweatshirt, really soft on the inside. I also got that. But yeah, thanks for watching. If you have questions, or comments, please leave them down below. And we'll see you guys sometime in the future. Thanks, bye. I also wanted to show you, the candy that I got from the Oogie Boogie Bash. I've eaten a lot of it already, but I think I got like 2 or 3 pounds of candy. It was a lot. And some of my own snacks are mixed in here that I took, but like we got onions. I've never seen these in Canada. They're crunchy cookie. And then we got full size Rice Krispie treats, goldfish, more goldfish, Skittles, raisins. Pirate's candy, which we don't have in Canada, at least I've never seen it. Oh, and then we got like a lot of Snickers, a lot of Twix. We also got Starburst. So this isn't even all of it, because some of it's my own snacks I brought, and then I've eaten a lot. So you definitely get your money's worth out of the candy for that, the price of that. I think my ticket was $160. And I mean, you got so much experience in that party, and you got so much candy, and you saw great entertainment. So I think it's worth it. Definitely worth it. I love the party so much. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.